once again welcome.
And let's begin from our next part. In the last part, we have discussed that long conversation had happened between Mr. Lamb and Derry. They talked about bees singing. Here Derry explains that he would never entered garden if he had seen Mr. Lamb sitting there. Now let's move ahead. Here we can see that Derry further said that if he would enter his garden even after knowing that he was there, it would be trespassing. Trespassing, what do you mean by trespassing? It means that to enter someone's place without any notice. You might have read at many places that trespassers are prosecuted. Let us take the example of our school. Other people are not allowed to enter the premises as this property belongs to Rotary English Medium School. So, if the person whosoever owns the land, they do not allow other people to enter their premises or enter their place. So others couldn't enter the place without giving the notice to them. See here, we can see that Mr. Lamb said, that was the reason. And then he said that it was not the reason. So here when he asks, Derry said, no, it was not the reason. And now you will see that what reason Derry gives. He told he does not like to go near to the people as they get afraid of him and they just stare at him. This was one sort of tactics you can see Mr. Lamb used to make Derry speak freely to him. Now Derry told the real reason for not entering the gate. You can see that how beautifully Mr. Lamb tries to convert him into positivity for every negativity. Mr. Lamb tries to bring his attitude in a positive way. So moving towards our next slide, we'll see that here further Mr. Lamb suggested that he could lock himself in the room. If he does not like any people to meet, he should lock himself and stay in the room forever. And then he started narrating the story. And the story goes, how it goes, that he told there was a man who locked himself in his room as he was afraid of everything. The man thought he would met with an accident with a bus. He would have catch deadly virus. Now you all know which is the dangerous virus, that's corona. So we all are scared of corona, but at that time when the story was written, nobody knew about that. So such type of virus would enter and he would be killed. Further he says that donkey would kick him to the death, lightning could happen. To safeguard himself from all the incidents, man locked himself in the room. And Derry surprisingly asked, was he locked forever? Here you can see Mr. Lamb replies that no, only for a while. He was locked for a while. Derry interestingly asked him, what happened next? Mr. Lamb replied that the picture fell on the head and he died. And on this, Derry laughed a lot. He was very happy to listen. And that smile, which smile Mr. Lamb wanted to see, he could see on Derry's face. Then he says, he tries to lock himself to save his life. What happens? Ultimately, he's dead by a picture. So here, you can see how once again Mr. Lamb tries to narrate the story, and what is the impact of that story we will see in the next slide. Here you can see on seeing Derry laugh on the man's incident, Mr. Lamb says him, you see this you see is very important part, underline it. Here Mr. Lamb wants to explain Derry that destiny cannot be changed. Things happen which is destined in our life. So why to fear? Thinking about it, why to feel sad? Whatever God has given us, we have to accept it. Here indirectly, Mr. Lamb addressed Derry that they all are people. They will speak. Why you are trying to ruin your Your face is never going to change. The fear which he has should be removed from his heart. Self-hatred which he has for himself should be taken out. He should learn to live. And so, further, he says, you see, it happens, move ahead. But Derry says, you speak strange things. He narrated strange talks, Derry feels. Mr. Lamb said, it may be strange for some. Derry asked, what? Mr. Lamb did all the day. He replied that he sat in the sun. He read books. He said that Derry thought that it was an empty house. And so, now this house is full of books and so many other things. So Derry looked at the house and said that there weren't any curtains on the windows. Why it is so? Here Mr. Lamb replied that he didn't like curtains. Shutting things in, shutting things out. Just underline these words. Further, he added that he liked light and darkness. What do you mean by that? Please underline these words also. Here, he means to say that he likes transparency. He likes light, darkness. He likes darkness. He likes light. And he likes the wind too, to listen to the sound of the wind. So, moving towards our next slide, let's see what happens. See here, we can understand that Mr. Lamb appreciates everything which comes in the life. With very small, minute things, he tries to remain happy. He values for each and everything, whether it may be tiny thing or whether it may be the big thing. He doesn't like to trap anything and put cover on them. Here, he likes to experience everything. He likes light and darkness. See, a light and darkness have a broad meaning. Happiness and sadness are the two cycles of our life. Here he wants to say that he enjoys happiness as well as he accepts the sorrows. Listening to Mr. Lamb's words, let's see what Derry says. Here he added, he also liked the sound of rain falling on the roof of his house. See students, here this is the second time he opened his heart. He poured his heart in front of Mr. Lamb and he shared that what things he liked. This statement tries to make him understand or make us understand that Derry too had some feelings, but that was corroded inside his heart because it was so much difficult and painful for him that people had always ignored him. So here, let's see when he see Derry accepting and sharing his liking, Mr. Lamb was happy. On this, Mr. Lamb commented, Derry was not completely lost in his pain. He was present-minded as he could hear and like some things. He could listen. Mr. Lamb says, there are something which is hidden in you somewhere, but it's there. On this, further, Derry states his family is worried about his burnt face, as what he will do. How he will do once his parents are gone. However, he will get on this world with his face. He has to live with this burned face. Further, he says he has listened to his parents conversing when he is upstairs and his parents converse about him when parents are downstairs. It really pains Derry when his parents talk him in this way. He does not like that parents speak wrong about him, and he wants that if parents are not ready to accept such type of face, or if they feel pity on him, why others will not speak about him. So next slide, when we'll see in the next slide, we can see although Derry's parents don't want to hurt him. Here it's not that parents are intentionally hurting him. He listens this from his own parents. He feels heartbroken. His parents are not hurting him. They're worried about him. They're protecting him. This is the concern and overprotectiveness for their kid, which he was sharing with Mr. Lam. Here you can see that parents are tensed. See, protectiveness is important, but overprotectiveness is not, because it makes worry. Here you can see parents should make Derry to fight with the words, with the world, but here their words are making Derry feeble. They are making Derry weak. Their intention is not wrong, but tackling the situation with Derry's disability is wrong. The way how they deal with the Derry, or the way they show pitiness on Derry, is wrong. Here they should force Derry, or they should try to motivate Derry to fight with the world. This vision is making Derry negative, and this behavior of parents had really made Derry negative. With this, further Mr. Lam realized Derry's perspective needed to be changed, and so he said further that Derry had everything. He has two legs, he has two arms, he has two eyes, two ears, etc., etc. He wanted to make Derry realize that he had all the things which other people are deprived of. Still, there are many people in the world who don't have such type of things, because he has not seen the world. He feels that he is alone, deprived of the things, but there are many things which Derry has. But Mr. Lam says many of the people don't have such type of thing, and he has everything which he should have. He says he will get on the way he want like others. If he choose and set his mind, he can get better than others. He says Derry need to change his mind, his attitude. He can accomplish a lot in life if he determines to choose. Derry asked, how was it possible? In written, Mr. Lam replied, the same way as he had done. So, moving towards next, here you can see, now Derry is able to realize what Mr. Lam wants to say. But somewhere he doesn't want to accept it, so he tries to change the topic. Derry with curiosity asks Mr. Lam if he had any friends. Mr. Lam replied that yes, he had 100 of them. Derry further said, still he lived alone in this big house if he has 100 of friends? Because here you can see that Derry doubts whether he has friends or not. In written, Mr. Lam said, everyone has friends everywhere. He told people come in, people go out. Everyone knew him. The gate is always open. They sat there by fire in winter season. Kids come to pick up apples and pears. Also, he told that they come to take honey toffees made by him. Anybody comes here, anybody comes in the garden, like Derry. Derry suddenly said that he was not his friend. Mr. Lam replied, certainly Derry was his friend, as he had not done any such type of thing which Mr. Lam didn't like. But Mr. Lam replied, certainly Derry was his friend, as he had not done any such thing that should cease their friendship and think for not being his friend. Here, let's move towards next. You can see how beautifully Derry answers. Derry answered that Mr. Lam doesn't know him, even he didn't know from where he comes from. And even moreover, Mr. Lam does not know his name. So Derry feels they don't know each other to make friends. Then how can Mr. Lam consider him as a friend? Mr. Lam did not consider that to be important. He told, it's not needed. Is it needed to write the particulars down in the filing box to find a good friend? So Mr. Lam told, is it necessary to know the data of a person before making friends? Like he says, name, age, address, occupation, all this should be written before making friends? So before moving further, just try to understand the thought process Mr. Lam is trying to create in Derry's mind. How real man he was. He was so kind and friendly. Generally, how you all choose the friends? You all have your friends, right? You all cannot live without friends. And at this age, your peer pressure is a must. You like your friends, somewhere sometimes you fight with your friends, sometimes you make new friendship. So how do you choose your friends? Yes, some of you like the nature of that child, some of you like the looks, some of you choose the status of the friend, of the person, or someone likes the habits. See, there are many reasons to find the friends, and we all choose the friend with some reason. Here, his choice resembles me, okay? So he's like me. So such type of sentence you speak. You sometimes you say, oh, this and I am his, I'm his friend because we both like to share these things. So here, you have some reason to choose the friend. But in mind, somewhere, we have to checklist how the friends are. But if you will see in Mr. Lamb's mentality, the things are quite different. Mr. Lamb think very high. Here, he doesn't think about any negative or ill things about any people. For him, everyone, everywhere, whoever he meets are their friends, are his friends. So we can see how Mr. Lamb said Derry that he could tell his name if he wished for. Yo, Derry replied that his name was Derek, but he disliked it and wanted to be called as Derry. He further says that if he is Mr. Lamb's friend, it doesn't mean Mr. Lamb has to be his friend. So he also added he might not visit the place in future. Then how they will remain friends forever? So Mr. Lamb asked the reason for not visiting. So Derry replied that one crosses many people in life while walking the street. They might speak to few of them, and it does not mean that they all have become their friends, whoever they meet. See, this is the thing which they have conversed with each other. On this, Mr. Lamb comments that it does not mean that those were enemies as well. Either if they are not friends, they aren't enemy. So Derry said that they were nothing, they are just people. Here Mr. Lamb said that it could not be that people were nothing to each other. See, please underline these lines. Here you can see that Mr. Lamb emphasized on importance of people, how the people are important in our life. Is it possible for all of us to live alone? See, just now there is lockdown. We have gone through this phase. You have seen that since last 3-4 months you are not attending the school. You have never seen your friends. So now you feel that when the school will start and when we will meet our friends. So as we are social animal, we cannot stay alone. We need people around us. And so same thing Mr. Lamb wants to try to emphasize Mr. Derry. He says that no person is nothing. Every person has its or her value. Mankind is important. So every person is important. Derry said that, but there were some people whom he hated. So further, moving ahead, we can see that Mr. Lamb replied that hatred would harm him more than the acid that had only affected his face. Acid had only burnt his face. See these lines, these all lines are very important. Please mark it in your textbook. Here, Derry painfully asks only. Here means he is trying to make Mr. Lamb understand that how he can say only. He feels that how easily Mr. Lamb tells only for his burnt face. But before moving further, let us have a look on these statements. See here, it's very important for us to understand what Mr. Lamb want to convey the message. Why he says so? See, it's so because Mr. Lamb has conveyed very important message to Derry. Here he means to say that hatred, the hate the self-hatred which he has in his mind for himself as well as for others, that corrodes or kill us from inside. It hurts such that acid doesn't hurt. Here he wants to say that acid gives pain from outside, that is external pain. We get physical pain, but hatred, it kills you totally. It kills you from inside. Negativity itself doesn't allow a person to stand or think properly. He wants to say that physical or external pain can be recovered, but the pain from internal soul disturbs you mentally and emotionally. Further, he says that like a bomb which only blew up his leg. But there were worst things that could happen. So he says that yes, bomb has removed his leg, the leg is blown off, but maybe there would have some worse thing which would happen with him. He would have burned himself from inside and brought negative feelings, but he's not. Here Mr. Lamb says his face is burnt externally. He wants to explain Derry that even though his face is burnt externally, he should not try to burn internally. He should try to understand the attitude as a human. As a human, we should have positivity in ourselves. So let's move towards the next slide and see what he suggests further. Here you can see, before moving, here we can see that there are three things which Mr. Lamb uttered and he has the different perspective to understand. See, he wants to say we should love all men. Without kindness, we cannot live. Second, he says that hatred is unnatural and it is injurious to mankind. And then he says, love is the solution for all the disease. We should try to love everything. Even if someone hates you and you try to love that person or that thing, automatically that person or thing will like you. After that, Derry said that when he had written from the hospital, a lady said that it was better if he had remained there with people like him. He added that people think all disabled people should remain together at one place. Mr. Lamb said means people with no legs altogether has to stay at one place. So here when he listens that Derry tries to tell that what he had heard that those women telling, he felt a little bit disturbed, and Mr. Lamb told that is it blind people has to live with blind people, disabled people have to live with the other disabled people, if the person does not have leg they have to stay with that those people. Further, here he states that he also added that if it would be a world like that, then the world would be imbalanced. What the world would look like if all the people would stay in that condition? So Derry replied, at least there would be nobody to stare at, as they were not like them. They all were similar, they all were same. So no one would have taunted him, no one would have told him anything. Further, he added that everything has similar appearance. He added that everything was different, although all things are same. Here we can see that there is a very broad perspective of Mr. Lamb. Here you can see he wants to convey that it would be more harm than good. Handicap will hurt more and they will become more and more miserable. How will they learn to lead a successful life? It will not be a world, it would be hell in this world. So here, if we find the deeper meaning of Mr. Lamb, what he wants to convey is that everyone has same feelings, everyone has same aspiration, everyone has same goal, but internally all are different. If you see the external existence of the people, we all are similar. But internally, we all are different. Our attitude is different. We all are unique. God has created us in a unique way. He wants to say that we have different nature, we have different qualities, we have different perspective in life. So here he gives the example and he says, means here, if you will take the example of twins, suppose twins look same, they are similar, but both are different. How they are different? Because their likes, dislikes, behavior, interest, everything differs. So same statement here Mr. Lam wants to share with us. So please underline these lines. So here, for then, with listening to this, Derry got confused. Mr. Lam told, our habit of listening, watching and thinking makes us different from each other. So when all these things were listened by Derry, he got confused. He told, how it can happen? Even though we are similar, how can we be different? And when he listened to that, he told that how it could be. So here, this listening, speaking, whatever, these three lines or three words which Mr. Lam tries to tell is that it depends on us, what you think, what you listen and how you express the actions. Okay, so now let us move towards the next slide. Here further you can see Derry expressed that he liked Mr. Lam's house and garden. He said that Derry was always welcome there as gate was always open. But Derry said it was not his place. Mr. Lam said everything was his if he wanted to be. See here you can see Derry expressed he liked Lam's house. Here you can see one more time he has shown that what he likes and he's trying to show the positivity. So here further you can see, if you see the deeper side of the words, you can understand that Mr. Lam means to say that if he desire, he can get it. Here you can see that he added that all his possession were for everyone. He wants to say that it is his wish. If he shows his desire, he can get anything in the world. So he shows here and tries to explain universal brotherhood. Here we can see the nature of Mr. Lam is different. He is very kind hearted. He believes in sharing, as one day he feels that possession of one's thing is useless. See, take the example of us. We all know who, those who are born have to die one day. Even though till we just continue to exist, what we do? We try to possess the things under our control. We feel that these are mine, all thing which we decide is about our possession. And so here Mr. Lam tries to say that we have to think about universal mankind. Further Derry asks if he could visit the place again. So Mr. Lam told certainly yes he could, where he could find others company as well. So here he says yes he could come, but maybe sometimes he may see some other people as well in the garden. So Derry replied that probably they wouldn't enter the place seeing Derry, because maybe if they look at Derry's face, they all would get scared away and run. So here we can see once again Derry goes in the negative perspective, because he feels that if he stays in the garden, other people who is there at Mr. Lam's garden will not like to see Derry, because his face is burnt and everybody is scared of him. So further we can see that Mr. Lam replied, they might or might not, means they may be or may not be. But here he says that he has to take a chance, he has to take a risk. See, we have to take a risk in our life. We cannot assume what is going to happen with us in the next moment. So each and every person has to take the risk. And so he just suggests Derry to take a risk. So Derry told that Mr. Lam had to choose out of him and other people. If it happens that if he has to choose other people and Derry, definitely he will choose Derry and he will ask Derry to stay in the garden. So Mr. Lam said he would lose dairy if he was in the garden. So here further dairy says that if he will stay in the garden, once again he say Mr. Lamb that he will lose other friends. But then he added in that and he said, what when he went out the street, kids teased him, although they visit his garden and his house. It was like a game. They were not scared of them. See here what Mr. Lamb wants to try him to make Derry understand is that don't think that people always be scared of it. They show the expression but they forget it. Even though we should try to forget it and we should consider it as a game, because people are not always scared of us because they get used to with us. And then Derry asked suddenly that if his leg was blown off in the war. So here further we can see Mr. Lamb replies. Let's see what he replies. He replies, yes, certainly. So Derry asked with concern if he could help him to pluck the apple. See here now you can see that he likes Mr. Lamb and he wants to help Mr. Lamb to pluck the apples. Mr. Lamb said that he could help him if he wanted to. So Derry said that his mother would be waiting. Now he told, means indirectly he wants to say it's getting late, and now he remembered that his mother would be waiting for him. And he told, further stated that his home was 3 miles away across the fields. He was 14 years of age, but still he has to be, he was supposed to tell his mother where he was. So here he wants to tell that even though he is grown up, he has to tell each and everything to his mother. So in this, Mr. Lamb told that because they feel worried about you. But Derry added, telling that no, they fuss. What do you mean by fuss? Fuss means that they create big issues with very small things. So Derry feels that when they will come to know that he had visited Mr. Lamb's garden, they will just not get worried, but they will create fuss. So Mr. Lamb asked Derry to go and told to inform his mother of his whereabouts, because mother would be worrying about him. But his house was 3 miles away. So he told, even though your house is 3 miles away, weather is so fine, you have 2 legs. You could go easily to your house and tell them, and then you can return back. So moving towards our next slide, let's see what answer Derry gives. Derry added once that he told, if he goes once, he goes to his home, he will never return back. Because here his parents will not allow him to go. See, this is the main nailed which is nailed by the Mr. Lamb. You can see how pinpointing Mr. Lamb speaks, and he tries to give the challenge further, and he suddenly says, you yourself will not allow you to come back. Your parents may allow you, but you will never allow yourself to come back. See, this is the important sentence here. Mr. Lamb tries to challenge him. He's trying to nail him that once if he is going to get challenged and if he has changed the attitude, definitely he will give the answer in positive. And then what answer he gets, let's see. He said, He said, he will come. He knows. Mr. Lamb says, yes, you know it. How others can know about you, what you want to do? So Derry says, yes, I can if I choose. See, here I choose is very important. For us also, every time there are 2 ways in our life. It depends on you, how you choose. If you choose to go ahead, you can go in a proper way. But if you try to choose the negative things, you will go in a wrong direction. So here also we have learned that if you choose, you can get and you can decide, you can do whatever you want. And Mr. Lamb said, yes, if you choose. And then he told, he can't tell what he has to do. Let's see what happens next. Yeah, now to confirm about the friends. Now Derry asks the names of Mr. Lamb friends. So, Mr. Lamb told the names like Tom, Dick, Harry. We all know that these all are idioms. So, here randomly he told those names. So, we can understand that Mr. Lamb may not be having the names of the friends. And so, just randomly he told Tom, Dick and Harry. Many times if we don't know the names, we try to take those names. Then he said he has to live to see the bees. Derry said that Mr. Lamb was mad. Mr. Lamb said that was a good excuse for Derry. But in return, Derry told Mr. Lamb didn't talk sensible, and so he said or uttered those words. Once again, here you can see that Mr. Lamb emphasized ahead that here you can see Mr. Lamb emphasized on the point to challenge him for not returning to the garden. Once again he says that you will have a good reason that your face was burnt, and that was other people's excuse. So moving further, we can see that Derry is becoming positive. He says that Mr. Lamb was like other people. Here you can see that when Mr. Lamb pinpoints him, he feels bad. And if he was not sorry, then he was scared of him. These things he is talking to himself. So Derry told that Derry was as ugly as a will. But here you can see that Mr. Lamb doesn't reply. Mr. Lamb told if he doesn't think in such a way. So here, after some time, you can see that Mr. Lamb has gone to see his bees. Now Derry is quiet and says to himself that Mr. Lamb is not like that. So here, first he talk about Mr. Lamb. No, he thinks like this, he thinks like that, he thinks me as a devil, or he thinks me as an evil. But then he understood, no, he talks to himself. He told, no, he's not like others, he cares for me. And then he talked to himself, and then he takes pause. Then he shouts, I'm going, but will surely come back. You see, you wait, I can run, I have got a thin leg, I will be back. So see, this sentence shows that he is very happy to go, and he is happy to listen to Mr. Lamb, and he wants to come back. And see, just mockingly he tries to tell he has this teen leg and all. And then what happens is Derry runs off, and there is a silence, and there is garden noise once again. Before going towards the bees, while walking, Mr. Lamb talked to himself. Everyone say they will come back, but no one returns to the garden. Here we can understand that Mr. Lamb is alone. He lives in solitude. He is detached with everyone. He is very lonely. He has no friend. But as he is optimistic, he finds good in everyone. But the sentences reveal wanting for someone. Here we can see that Mr. Lamb likes to do a friendship with everyone, but there are no people with whom he can talk. So here you can see that we have come to the end of scene 1. So now we will move towards scene 2. Now here you can see the second scene is at Derry's house. Derry is talking to his mother. His mother asked, what did Derry think of her? She had already heard about Mr. Lamb. Derry told her not to believe others said. See here, these sentences are very important. Here you can see the transformation in Derry's words. These are the words which are influenced by Mr. Lamb. Here you can see some positivity, and then he talks to his mother. But here you can see mother warns him that what she requires to be known about any person, and therefore he asked him not to go back. She did not leave here for 3 months. She knows this place and she has heard much about Mr. Lamb, and so she denies to go once again back to Mr. Lamb's place. Derry asks reason for this fear. He told that Mr. Lamb was just an old man with a thin leg. He has big house without curtains and has a garden. But he further says that he wants to listen and look. Suddenly, mother asks what he wants to listen. And Derry replies he wants to listen beast talking, him talking. So further, mother asks and she wanted to know what he will say to Derry. So what he was going to talk to Derry. But she didn't find it suitable answer. With what Derry replies, he told things that matter for him. See, things that matter for him, these are the important sentences. Nobody had ever talked to him in such a way. Here you can say that Derry started liking Mr. Lamb. Here he feels that Mr. Lamb understands Derry. He tries to kick point all the positive attitude in Derry. And so now Derry is somewhere attached with Mr. Lamb. So he wanted to think as per his own choice what Mr. Lamb has told him. But mother refused and asked him to stay at home. Now in the next slide further we see that he hated to remain at home. Here it's given that he does not like to stay at home, he says. But his mother excused him for speaking such a wrong thing. He was bound to speak, she says, because he feels bad for his face and told that she shouldn't blame him for that. So here once again you can see that mother is partially responsible for Derry's negative attitude. She never motivated him. Still, she is not able to accept Derry's face. Here we can see that once again she has brought burnt face. Here we can see that Derry was partially becoming positive. But even though mother once again tries to show that what disability he has. And such type of attitude had created somewhere. This is the reason where you can see that Derry has become negative. But at last he announced that he would go back into the garden and help Mr. Lamb with crab apples. His mother tried to stop him, but he said he has to. If he not today, then never he will be able to go. See, this is also the important sentence. Here, this statement shows the transformation in Derry. Challenge which he has accepted, he chose it positively. He is ready to fight with himself. He is ready to break all the barriers and want to live a meaningful life. He is ready to fight with the society, with the people. And he wants to live this life accompanying with Mr. Lamb. Suddenly, he runs. The door slams. He runs. He pants. He shouts, I want the world, I want it, I want it, I want it, and then the noise fades away. Now we'll see the scene 3. Here, this scene 3 takes place in Mr. Lamb's garden. We can hear the sound, the noise of the branch shifting, apples thumping down, branch shifting again, and Mr. Lamb talking to himself. While he was plucking the apples, he was talking to him. And then suddenly there was a harsh sound, a click, a crash. The ladder falls back and Mr. Lamb falls with it. The branch swishes back, clicks, and there is silence. Suddenly Derry opens the gate. Still he is panting. He is breathing very rapidly. And Derry says, you see, I came back. You said I wouldn't. And they said, but I came. I came back. I wanted to. He stops. He stops like a statue. He's still. Mr. Lamb starts crying. Mr. Lamb, you have. He runs through the grass, stops, and then he kneels down. He starts crying. Say, Mr. Lamb, it's all right. You have fallen down. I'm here. Mr. Lamb, I'm here. It's all right. I came back. Let me, Lamb. I came back. And this way we can see the story ends. The author has stopped a story here, and we can get the idea that as there is no noise from Mr. Lamb, we feel that he's dead, he's no more. But before going, he has tried to change the attitude of Derry. He has brought the positivity, he has made optimistic view of Derry. And by this we can understand that one person in our life can make a change. Here I remember about a movie which is Dior Zindagi, which was played by Shah Rukh Khan and Alia Bhatt. Here this movie is related somewhere to this story. Here we can see that Alia Bhatt was totally negative, and the character was like Derry. Means she had played a negative character, and Shah Rukh Khan was a psychiatrist, where we can see that Mr. Lamb has played this role. Here we can see that this film urges us to love our imperfect, messy and flawed lives, same which we can see in this play. We can see that Shah Rukh Khan, like Mr. Lamb, lights up Alia's dim life, like how Mr. Lamb had lightened up the life of Derry, giving out pieces of advice that showed him a way, him a straight way. We can see that Mr. Lamb tried to show the new perspective of his life. So dear students, now with this story or with this play, we have to think a lot. There is a deep meaning that what this play wants to tell us. See, somewhere or somehow we all have problems. We should fight with those problems. In fact, we should not try complaining about all these things. So what moral we get from this? It's express yourself. Take the steering wheel of your life in your own hands. Don't be very hard to yourself. You should try to love yourself. Don't let your past ruin your present or your beautiful future. So at last, my dear students, I just want to tell that be mindful of your thoughts. Your thoughts will change your words. Your words will change your action. Your action will change your habit. Your habit will try to change your character. And your character will change your destiny. So, as Mr. Lamb told, the same thing I want to tell you all, that it's you who chose your life. It's you how you choose your life. It's you how you take up your life. And if you will take the right choice, the world is yours. So, I would like to end my session with this, telling you that be motivated, be hardworking, and try to do whatever you think for and whatever you strive for. Thank you and bye.